previously on Dave's World of Fun Stuff. Oh, we pulled a bunch of frets out of that old Hofner. Well, guess what we're going to do? We're going to do some more fret pulling on a Tokai Silver Star. Definitely a big lawsuit deal. Guy owns it, did a home refinish with the Mohawk rattle cans from Solo Guitars. Came from those guys. And turned out pretty nice. It's all about the prep, really. The spraying is just the fun part. So, what do we want to talk about? Oh yeah, the last video, I gotta say something about that. So in the last video, I know I made a really long video and I played a few sound bites of old demos and songs from yesteryear with my good buddy Gus Pappas. At the end of the video, okay, anybody who's ever watched my videos, okay, at the end of the video, I've had to modify it slightly, but I'm going to make a new end segment, I guess is what we want to call it. There's the drums and the bass guitar playing, right? Boom. Okay, that's me and a guy named Jack Fuller, and that's a little sound bite out of a song that I wrote, that I have the entire song, I have the demo. So YouTube, out of all those little sound bites and everything, I guess their AI robot got so frustrated that it flagged my little end segment with my bass playing and said it was something that Jimi Hendrix did. I'll take the compliment, but I don't know, folks. Like I said, there was 800, not, I'm not going to say 800, there was 8 sound bites of stuff that sounded like rock music, and at the end somehow I became Jimi Hendrix on the bass. Stay tuned for that. Let's get this going because I'm bored and it's raining outside. So I did figure out that the truss rod worked, so I'm just gonna loosen the strings. Everybody sort of liked the long format video, so I mean, I don't care if you don't mind listening to me do nothing. See, that's why, like, when I do the, what do I call them? The donkey jobs? When I do the donkey jobs, I, you know, listen to music sometimes. These poor old tuners. I'm wondering when this thing was made. Someone may know. Let's get the strings off and the neck. We're also going to need to replace the nut. Two reasons for that. The frets are so low that this nut would never work anyway when I put new medium jumbo frets on it. And it's got a chip and we've got to get rid of that too. That's all. Look, it's Skycam. Okay, before I take this apart, I get right in there and show you. See how all the screws are all mangled? Oh, it has a tilt thing. We'll see if it actually works. Or I don't like using that, to be honest with you. It's just. But back to this. This is made in Japan. Okay, those are JIS screws, right? JIS, Japan Industry Standard. They look like a Phillips. I don't even have a... They look like a Phillips, but they're not. So if you want to, you know, be square and be a pro and not make these do what they do, get a JIS set of screwdrivers that look like Phillips that actually fit the screws. But it's kind of a thing I see, and it's not a good thing. Okay? Over and out. Okay, it's got all the tilt stuff, the little set screws there. Yeah, I can see the neck's been taken off a lot of times, so when we get to reattaching it, we might want to fill those a little bit. Let's make the neck straight, and I'll show you what I'll be doing next until I cook my chicken dinner. I used to say this at work to folks, okay, everybody, the next step in the cooperation, instead of saying operation. The next step in our cooperation will be turn the straight edge the right way around and make the wood straight. And right now she's got a little back bow in it. This is another one that's probably going to turn out really good. Opening this loosens off just a bit. I was playing with it. Yeah, man. There's another issue that's going to get fixed as well. So, reminding myself about things I need to do. On the back of the neck, there's a big divot. I mean, you never see it, but it's right where your hand goes, and it feels like you got a pimple on the base of your thumb when you're playing in the first position. Okay, what's up next? Well, I'll show you what's going to be up next. Well, actually, let's just knock that nut out of there and get it out of the way because I don't want to look at it anymore.
It's Dave's week of generosity here. I'll just say, I'll show you a little trick. A Fender neck, if you take it and the headstock is over the edge of the bench, the flat edge on the back, and it'll just sit flat, perfectly flat. And if you put it, I don't know, you see over here, right? If you can put it over there, you can actually clamp it down there if you need to. So like when I'm yanking frets on something that pops out, I don't need a big fancy vise, and I'd rather have it laying flat on my table where I can feel it. So when I see all these big things that grab things and move it, and it's just like, it's just there. It's that easy. Let's smash that out of there. I'll just keep rolling because you guys like hanging around me. This is the same exacto knife I'll be using to score all the way along. Every fret, so that this stays on when I yank them out. But we never know how much Mr. McGlue is in there, so it's always a good idea just to give it a little score along there. I'll do the back side. And notice I'm using the back of the X-Acto knife first. All right. That just gives me enough to break the heavy lacquer, because if you use the super sharp side first, it tends to go all over the place. That's just my experience. Ba-doom. See, like that, just like a little spaghetti swirl of lacquer that came out of there. Okay, I will get a clamp and clamp it at the other end so it doesn't wiggle around, and I'm going to bash that out of there. You can use whatever device you like as long as it's designed to be smashed on, and it's not wider than the nut, because if it's wider than the nut, you're going to hit the wood and you're not going to pop out. So, like I said, I'm clamped up down here, a little spring clamp on there. I don't line it up against my belly, because then I can feel how hard I'm hitting stuff. If I've got it in a vise, all clamped tight, and then I smack this, I can't really put a barometer or a thermometer or a speedometer on. There we go. So at that point, when it starts to move, don't keep smashing. Don't keep smashing, because smashing is over. Now I'm going to get the same tool I'm going to use to pull a fret. So I'm going to grab that and wiggle it a bit. And just try and pull it out. See, it comes out in chunks. If I had kept hammering it, there, came out nice and clean. Beautiful. Next.
Well, I'm going to wind down on this one. All right. See, this is like Zen work, you know? Real Zen work. Do a couple frets. Have a sip of beer. Walk away. Because bending over the bench sucks. Well, it depends why you're bending over the bench, I guess, but hey, bending over the bench while getting sucked, now there you go. I don't know if I could run this X-Acto knife. So I'm going to go all over everything one time with the back side of this, not the front. And then we'll go over it all again with the really, really sharp, sharp side. And then I'm going to pull them all out. But anyway, I'd just like to say, hey, thanks to all my patrons. Please become one. I had a great idea. Wow. Everybody that comes out to my live stream, or anybody that was in the Facebook group that's now gone forever, I don't want to make another one. I think you can still look at it, but I'm nixed from being part of it. That being said, yeah, there, that phrase, right? When you use that in a conversation, right? So it's just like that phrase. That being said, that means you're going to fucking say something else, but what you just said was just the beginning of... Oh, yes. That being said, we could have a big old private party, internet party. A patron party. Maybe that's what I'll do. We'll have a patron thing. But anyway, check it out. Get a sticker. You can Twitter me. Like I said, Twitter is still rocking and rolling. And I look at it once in a while. If you go to the head of my channel, if you really want to contact me, okay? If you go to the, like, instead of watching my video, go like to the big, you know, where the channel is. On one side of there, I'm pretty sure there's a whole way to get a hold of me. I think somebody did the other day. I haven't heard back. Who knows? Don't cut yourself. So this is why I'm using the back side, right? It's the childproof side. So when I go, All right, I'm going to sign off. What we learned today, JIS screwdrivers on things that are made in Japan. We smashed our nut out of this. I got a new one coming. I got some brand new Fender medium jumbo frets, which are a little bit wider than this. So when I pull this apart, if there's any, you know, things we don't like, on there, but I should be able to preserve the lacquer, and if I can't, well then I just touch it up best I can. I gotta recheck the straightness on this, but okay, kids, folks, moms, dads, grandmas, grandpas, aunts, uncles, everybody in between, check out the description below for things that could happen, and what else? Oh yeah. Be safe and be good to each other. Cheers. Okay, this is the song with the original. I don't care. I want to see what AI does. We'll take the segment out if they bone me. I was much younger when I sang this. Don't bore us. Get to the chorus. We'll be right back.
know you got to get in here right from the first. It's out there, it's hidden inside a purse. No, you got to get it right from the first.
Here it is, right? It's just bass and drums. There you go, right? Okay, that's a real dog, okay? So the way that started in the studio when my friend Paul Martin was playing the slide guitar part, another friend of ours was hanging out and had his dog with us, with him, in the control room. And for whatever reason, the dog just really liked the slide guitar and started howling. So we just kind of thought it was cool. I think the dog's in key. I don't know. Did that dog pay to get in? That's my question.